I'm really fascinated by how people from different disciplines come together and build building projects. Disciplines like planning, design, construction, engineers, how do they come together in a project environment and communicate across organizations and disciplines so that we have better sustainable built environment products? And that's what really moves me in my everyday life. I was just, exposing myself to opportunities where I could have experiences in different settings so that I could actually test out what really works for me, what brings the best out in me and whatnot. I asked myself, what is important for me in my leadership role? And the first thing that comes to my mind is building a community around purpose. And I think that comes from those years of the leadership that I was exposed to under a woman. And today, whatever I am tasked with, the first thing I try to do, I try to build a community around a purpose. But when you have a community built around a purpose, then we all serve that purpose together. And I think it's magical once that's established. Problems that women face can be very gender specific. So what happens is we have to really juggle the professional life and personal life and try to maintain that balance. So in doing that, I believe it's very important to have a support system so that you can talk to the like-minded. And what sets you aside a lot of the time is your dedication to learning, to advancing yourself, and the fact that you keep at it. It's not just the quantity of people these mentors work with, but the quality of interactions that they can have. They need to have a lot of experience, work with a lot of people like these, but are able to also connect with the people that they work with. Then it really makes a difference. They're able to recognize the qualities and strengths in these people, and they're able to tell, you would just be really good for this type of opportunity. That also comes from my mother. I remember, it might be something cultural, we always had something for people to eat. And my mother was a person almost that force-fed people, right? So whenever I go to meetings or my students come to this space a lot, I always make sure my chocolate box is full or I have some nuts or some fruits that's on the side that's available. I really enjoy sharing.